Happy New Year! And what better way to ring in the new year is through pedophilia accusations. This is Pkrussl. There's a likely chance you may know him, but for those who don't, Pkrussl is a YouTube commentator, known for not only making videos surrounding cringe, but he also reviews, and that's putting it in loose terms, of animation memes, ones that are typically made by children. He has also been under fire recently for following a wide variety of artists who draw child porn, but also tried to hide all of it like a little bitch. But little does he know is that all of it was archived. Let's unpack it, shall we? Hey, Pomeranian Prince here while editing this video. First of all, I do want to address a couple of things before we truly get into the video. First of all, I am fully aware of Pkrussl's stream that he did in which he addressed the accusations. And let's just say it was a piece of work. There may be another video surrounding the live stream as it is almost 2 hours long. There are a lot of things to unpack and this video is likely long enough as is. Second of all, while we're on the subject of live streams, I'll be addressing one thing that he did talk about that I didn't bring up in this video. In the live stream, he mentions two artists that were brought up in the document, Fairwind1988 and Woo Woo. PK brings up the fact that if you look up their names on InkBunny, you would see that their profiles are empty minus some favorites. He is right on that, however, that is what happens when you look at their profiles when you have an adult slash mature content filter on. If you were to turn off that filter, you would see this. And just to note, these artists have never had any type of interaction with PK, nor do they follow him back, nor are they friends with him. There are no reasons for PK to be following these accounts. I'm not saying that he is a pedophile, but Pkrussl has a now recently archived InkBunny account in which he followed 109 artists that post cub porn. 39 of those artists draw cub porn extensively and/or exclusively. Cub porn, if you're wondering, is porn that surrounds underage furries. Basically, child porn. I'm sure many of you will yell at me and say things like how he only liked cub pics and hasn't abused any kids, and also how apparently those are just images, so therefore it doesn't affect reality. Yeah. Jaws would like to have a word with you. I know some of you guys are probably going to be clicking in the comments down below asking me how exactly this is PK. It's not his username and it could be a different person for all we know. And you would be right on that mark. But I would not be throwing a serious accusation of pedophilia if I didn't have the receipts. PK has a Steam account that not only he linked on his Fur Affinity, but also in his videos up to 2018. His name James is featured on said accounts alongside with his PSN and other interests. There are also archives of his DeviantArt and InkBunny with the name HS2012. However, if you were to click on the link of his InkBunny account, it would instead lead you to the username Voluptuous Vanessa. I'm sure a lot of you guys are probably using that fact as a gotcha card for debunking this. However, InkBunny allows you to change usernames and they keep record of it. This is very similar to DeviantArt's feature where it catalogs your changed usernames and even redirects you to the current username if you search for a previous one. Some other indicators that Vanessa is PK include the fact that not only do people refer to him as James, but also follow him on Facebook and DeviantArt, and also interact with him on InkBunny. And to top things off, this picture of Zeno the Hedgehog has been tagged under Pkrussl on various websites, and was also the icon used on PK's Steam account in 2013. How do we even know if the receipts are real, Pomeranian Prince? I hear you again tapping away in the comment section below. They could have been fabricated or even photoshopped. Didn't we learn anything from Pentagon and stories? Again, I would not blame you for doubting these claims. However, a lot of the evidence that I got from this were from web archives. Sorry to flex on my computer knowledge, but that's what happens when you get aid from an archivist. You cannot modify web archives. The only way you can do that is through hacking the server that the archive is on. Do you really think somebody would go as far as to hack a server for an archive website because they have a hate boner for PK? No, let's be fucking logical here. These archives date back to 2011. PK did not get his claim to fame until late 2017. His social blade shows that. This again shows that this wasn't done out of malice and that this is something we call facts. PK, as of this recording, has addressed the accusations by openly mocking and baiting people. Oh, and he's also threatening to sue people for defamation, despite the fact that he's confessed that he has barely been able to pay rent and has been hopping from one Airbnb to another. He claims he'll make a video about this, and it is unsure as to when he will actually make it. Oh, by the way, I just got notification that he recently purged his Fur Affinity account. Pkrussl claims that he was being overwhelmed with the traffic on his account, but keep in mind that Pkrussl said that you usually don't go about deactivating accounts on social media unless if you yourself are hiding something. This is the same logic PK applied when Mordecai privated and eventually deleted their account on Twitter shortly after the Kero the Wolf leaks. I'm not saying Pkrussl is a pedophile, however, don't you notice how quick, suspiciously quick I may add, he was in terms of defending Kero the Wolf when there was ample evidence of the heinous things he did? There's this little saying that goes, "Birds of a feather flock together." A lot of you guys are probably wondering why I am even making a video about this. You probably think I'm doing it because I'm trying to make money, or I'm using the latest controversy to make views. However, neither of those things are true. I am making this video because the animation meme community is comprised of preteens and teens. Basically, a lot of underage kids, and PK's audience overlaps with animation memes and him. Pkrussl's audience consists of primarily children. The last thing I want is for this smarmy fuckhead to start grooming and exploiting kids. It's already bad enough he got his fame through mocking children. And PK, because I know you're watching this video and you're probably reacting to it now and totally not being bothered by it, prove me wrong. I want to give you the benefit of the doubt. However, with all the evidence that is present, and I even relied on web archives, which, again, you cannot modify in any way, shape, or form without the aid of hacking tools in the server of the archive, you have a lot of explaining to do. Oh, and by the way, when you're dealing with a scandal like this, maybe you shouldn't be acting like Kevin Spacey and openly gloating about how you own the libs on confessing that you consume child porn, but what the hell do I know? I am the Pomeranian Prince. Thank you for watching.